Everybody wants better relationships, am I right? Because you and I both know that if your relationship sucks, then your life sucks. A lot of people have terrible relationships and they just don't even know why. They constantly keep fighting. They feel that their partner does not love them, does not support them, does not value them, or is not there for them when they need them the most. Let me tell you that these people are not bad people. They are good by heart. It's just that their relationships are lacking. And today, I want to give you a few tips on how you can nurture your relationships to create a deep bond, a deep connect with your partner. So the first thing is to support your partner's goals. You can never truly know a person if you don't know their goals. And if you don't know their goals, you can never be a great lover or a great supporter. Isn't it surprising that you don't know your partner's goals, whether they're long-term goals or short-term goals? What type of career are they interested in? What are their hobbies? Today, take a moment to actually reflect on their goals and see how you can help them. If you want to be a great spouse to someone, you have to re-engage and ask them, maybe tell them, hey, I know we have been through a couple of odd months or maybe even years. Maybe we were lost, but I want to be there for you. I want to support you in any way that I can. Please remember that people's goals change. Maybe what you wanted for yourself last year is not the same. What you wanted 2 years ago may not be the same. And if it is not the same for you, it may not be the same for your spouse as well. Understand the importance of the present stage. Also, you need to be open to sharing your goals with your partner, because if you can't share yours, then you can't expect your partner to understand and support you. A lot of times we feel that we can do it all alone. We don't need anyone else. But let me tell you that if you are doing it all alone, it is the exact opposite of having healthy, supportive relationships. In my case, I can tell you that my partner has always been there at each step. There was a time when I felt that I can be a fitness trainer. There was a time when I felt that I can be an English trainer. And I worked on both. And as I went deeper into it, I understood that these two were not for me. And then I decided to go on this life coaching journey and felt that this was for me. At each stage, my partner was there with me. At each stage, he was supportive. He was very, very supportive, and that is why I never felt lost. The second thing is understanding your partner's fears. We all have our feelings of unworthiness and days where we feel low, and we are so fearful of failing that we just stop chasing our dreams. Had our partner known that this is our weak point, this is where we are scared, maybe your partner can support you and help you grow at each stage. When this happens, your relationship does not stay stagnant. You are helping your relationship to grow. Maybe your partner is scared of losing you. He's scared if you just come late one day or if you don't reply to a text soon enough. You know, if you just know all this about your partner, you can preempt and maybe communicate in advance. You can communicate well before time. You can say that, I know this is an issue for you, sweetheart. I know this is a concern. And that makes your partner feel supported. That makes your partner feel loved. The third thing is to create unique, varied experiences. In the beginning of your relationship, you worked hard to do unique things like sending gifts, flowers, going out for romantic evenings. And now, even if you go out for a dinner, half of the time you're on your mobile phone. And even if you're at home, you'll be on the Netflix or YouTube. You never really spend that time together to create those magical experiences. You really have to do something to craft that magic. Maybe you can play a game together. Do something together, do more stuff together. Because if you work on your goals, and even if you work on your fears, and you're not working on creating new experiences, the magic in your relationship will soon go. So take a moment to actually think what you can do together. What is the new thing that you can do today in your relationship? Couples lose their charm in the initial stages itself, and then they wonder where the magic has gone and why their partner is so disinterested in them. The last thing is to share your journey together. You got to share your personal growth story. And when you actually share what you have learned, there is always a conversation that's going on. You can even share your struggles with your partner and ask for advice. That way you can connect deeper. Your partner also feels valued. You can share anything, share whatever you have learned, share this video, share any conversation that you had with your friend. When you add personal development, when you add personal growth to your relationship automatically grows. It becomes a happier relationship for sure. So the four key points to remember in nurturing your relationships are supporting your partner's goals, understanding their fears, creating unique, varied experiences, and sharing your journey together. I really hope you've liked this video, and if you have, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also, share it with your friends, and this video, do share it with your partner so that you can have a nurturing, supportive relationship. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you next week. Namaste.